Hi everyone, Hemant here. In this video, let's look at the way Adobe Flash Pro CC handles the legacy document files you might have saved using the earlier versions of Adobe Flash Professional. The two types of files we are talking about here are the FLA and XFL files. As Flash Pro CC continues to support both the formats, it is important to understand how it handles the files saved using the older versions of the authoring tool. Because of the backward compatibility, Flash Pro CC does open the older FLA and XFL file types, but once you open it and save it back using Flash Pro CC, it stamps the files with the latest version. Now you might think that the older versions of Flash Pro might not open this new file, but because of the forward compatibility, the older authoring tools, that is Flash CS5.5 and above, will open this file. However, one thing you might want to keep in mind is that some features have been dropped from Flash Pro CC. I'll give you more information on what features are deprecated, but when the older versions of these files are opened in Flash Pro CC, you are presented with warnings. These warnings will let you know which of the features are not supported anymore. This is the stage where you might want to make sure you save this new file as a separate copy instead of overwriting the old file. Once you save, none of the deprecated features are saved into the new file. Also note that since some of the older versions of Flash Pro can open new version of the files, Flash Pro CC also doesn't provide you with an option to save the files in an older format. You will just be allowed to save as an FLA or XFL file type. Some of the features you will not see being supported in Flash Pro CC are inverse kinematics. These are converted to frame-by-frame animations. TLF or text layout framework objects are converted to classic static text. Any code written in ActionScript 1 and 2 will be removed from any instance on the stage. ActionScript 2 components will now be considered as placeholders and you won't be allowed to use it to create new content on stage. Also, they will generate compiler errors in ActionScript 3. Lastly, the publish settings is defaulted to ActionScript version 3. I hope this information has helped all of you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.